Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'll be speaking on newer power modulation, high-end fluidics. We know that we have just now heard that power modulations which significantly reduce energy delivered to the eye and improve servant safety, and we have also seen the surge control mechanism which will safely allow high vacuum technologies. Now these are the three machines that we are going to talk about: the White Star Signature, the Centurion Vision System from Alcon, and Stellaris from Bausch & Lomb. Firstly, we will describe the Centurion Vision System, which is the newest system in PECO MLCPK, newest machine that we have. It has the power modulation, which is the same as the torsional Ozil IP. However, it's got something new called the balance tip. And the most important thing in the surge suppression is the active fluidics, which is very different from what we have already had, the gravity fled fluidics. Clogging is a problem in dense cataracts, and this Ozil has got what is called an Ozil IP with brief pulses of longitudinal phaco, which clear the clogging and keep fragments at the tip, and torsional phaco continues. This is a new tip. You must have seen the very funny type of cobra type of tip. It maximizes the torsion movement at the distant end, improves cutting efficiency, and it decreases CDE. It minimizes tip movement at the incision, and thereby decreasing the thermal energy. And also, most importantly, it supports surgeons who prefer a straight tip over an angled tip. That was one of the problems with the earlier machine where Infinity, where you had to use only a bent tip. Then you have got a good four-rib sleeve, which allows for adequate irrigation flow and better thermal safety. And normally we are used to active gravity-fed fluidics, but this active fluid technology, in contrast to the gravity-based irrigation system, maintains surgeon-selected target IOP, stable anterior chamber, and reduces surge. And this is how it is. A BSS bag fits into the special compartment between the two plates in the machine. Now, these plates can rapidly compress and decompress the fluid in the BSS bag to maintain the target IOP. This is a concept which is completely different. This is a concept in which you have no bottle. You don't have a bottle hanging there. And you have this BSS bag in the machine, and these plates contract and expand and maintain the intraocular pressure. When the patient's eye matches the PEL indicator on the machine, we can then correctly set the IOP. And let's see what. So the target intraocular pressure is now set at 55, which is equivalent to 75 millimeters of water by the gravity-fed system. The pressure sensors in the FMS system detect the irrigation pressure and the aspiration vacuum levels, and these two maintain the surgeon-selected intraocular pressure. So you have a surgeon-selected intraocular pressure which remains constant throughout the procedure, all throughout the procedure by this active fluidics. In spite of the leakage, still you have the IOP remains constant and you get a stable anterior chamber throughout the procedure. There are the new low-compliance aspiration tubings which are small bore, which also lead to surge control. And in this system, if the BSS runs out, the aspiration stops instantaneously. This is an additional safety factor. So what is active fluidics? It improves the chamber stability throughout the procedure with almost no surge. Consistent IOP level is there throughout the procedure. And you can operate at lower and safer intraocular pressure than the gravity-based system. This is very important in cases of glaucoma, where the optic nerve head is compromised. You can go to lower values, and you can actually operate at much lower target IOPs. Another additional factor in this machine is the differential setting of the vacuum and AFR. In front position 2, you can hold with a higher vacuum, And in foot position 3, you can emulsify at a lower and safer vacuum. So in the push position 3, you have a lower vacuum. In the foot position 2, you have a higher vacuum, which is not so in other machines. And therefore, you can again have a much safer, you have vacuum break at a much safer vacuum and a lower vacuum, thereby preventing surge. And this is what we are going to show in slow motion. This is the surgery that we are trying to show. I'll make it a little fast. You can see the fragment is emulsified. You see the vacuum, it rises to 300 when the tip is occluded. And as soon as this tip gets it unoccluded, you see that the vacuum drops. And you see the IP come on and off again and again. See, the vacuum has risen to, and now it's fallen to 116. And again rises, as soon as the tip is occluded, it rises to 300, 350. And as soon as the tip becomes bare, it falls to 200, 197. So this is what happens in position 2 and position 3. There's a differential of vacuum and flow rate. Now in the transversal phaco, it is simultaneously blends the longitudinal and transverse modes, and it is the longitudinal is a forward and back movement, the transverse is the left and right movement, which leads to an elliptical excursion of the phaco tip. Now the transversal component decreases repulsion, increases fallibility, and there's better holding and chopping. The longitudinal component prevents clogging and allows constant emulsification. The elliptical stroke enhances cutting efficiency, and this has already been dealt with. And there are two advanced fluidic mechanisms in this, the case and the occlusion mode. The case is a vacuum-based mechanism, and the occlusion mode is a flow-based mechanism. And this is the case vacuum, where the break and occlusion occurs at lower and safer vacuum. The vacuum is 500, but the vacuum breaks at 350, and the surge is decreased by 56%. And in the occlusion mode, there's a variation of FR in different stages of surgery. And on occlusion break, the pump starts at a slower rate and safer AFR, decreasing the surge. So you can switch over from the peristaltic to the venturi pump at any stage of surgery. And I think I'll cut this, as you can see. I think I'll skip over this because we've got two more speakers. This is just to show how when we are sculpting, look at the sculpting ability of this machine. At a brown black cataract, and they see the efficiency with which it sculpts. And this is the Stellaris vision system. There's nothing very great about the Stellaris vision system. They will now introduce a 6-character crystal handpiece for a better better cutting efficiency. And the fluidics is also not very great. They have introduced what is called a cruise control, which reduces the surge. There, wherein a modification of the aspiration tubing has been made, wherein the effective bore of the tubing is reduced to 0.3 millimeter. The nuclear fragments are aspirated from the entity chamber, are trapped in the mesh, thereby allowing the clear BSS fluid to pass through this narrow opening. This mesh prevents the clogging of the aspiration tubing, and the clear fluid passes through this 0.3 millimeter opening and therefore reduces the surge. And so the high end machines, there is a better utilization of ultrasound energy, there is better followability, minimal turbulence. They are good for dense brown cataracts, weak zonules, small pupils, and compromised endothelium. And therefore, you get better first postoperative day, you get clearer corneas with less thermal energy and less endothelial loss. Thank you very much.